think public art is art for everyone to see, and it's free to see.
To encourage people to like art.
It's there to show the public how like creative our culture is.
Because lots of people make wonderful stuff.
Public is like there for amusing people.
It's there to entertain people.
I think the public art is there to amuse people.
Look at it, talk about it.
Or inspiring them.
Yeah. Really exciting for children to see.
It's there to inspire people.
Inspiring people to do different things that to people look different.
Sometimes to tell stories about history.
Don't think about historical stuff that's something information.
Some people think that sculptures should be something.
Because most of the art you don't even know what it is.
What is it called?
The cockroach.
She was made by Richard Serra in 1987. It's very humongous. If you look and
I think they're gonna give it a bit of colour.
And it's made of metal, I think.
This sculpture, inside your voice changes because it gets louder and it echoes.
It's very humongous and it's in the shape of a pentagon.
To attract people.
Oh, I know. Maybe because the people come from the trains, so they might come from another place and they might see the sculpture. That's why
it just draws attention to one place.
When they come, they think, oh, this place is really nice. They've got nice pictures and stuff.
Then you would just like to go again and you would enjoy looking at it, no matter how many times you see it.
If there was like a centre, yeah, when people walk, because it's really crowded, people don't like it when there's something coming out of nowhere so that they have to walk around it.
Kind of big and roomy.
I think it's quite nice
because it shows how things balance, and it's really nice when you go inside because it's sort of like a shelter but it has no proper roof.
It makes you feel calm, and if it's like raining, just go over here, but it's still got a hole up there, but just go somewhere else that leads there. Because if it's a quiet place, you...
It reminds me of a tunnel.
Yeah,
a
tunnel where you go, ah, and it goes, ah. It's old.
That you liked?
I think it's going to fall down.
Please don't take no films on the estate, because it's a private estate, all right?
Yep.
Okay, you've got, if you want filming, you've got to get permission from the estates, okay?
Okay.
He won't let us film some of the statues.
That's right.
Why is it public?
There should only be some people there.
They shouldn't be there, then.
In there, only security people.
If
you're from a different country, then you won't know what the rules are.
No,
they said we're not allowed.
Why?
I don't know.
She said we're not allowed to.
Why?
I don't know.
This one we could film if we just filmed the sculpture in the building.
One, two, three.
I don't like when there's just things that you just have to see, and then it's really boring just looking at things and you can't touch it. I like when you feel it and you get to understand why it's there and how it feels.
All ages and abilities, so if you're blind, you can still have fun because you're feeling it and you have a picture in your mind of what you think it would look like.
It's a sign.
Maybe
it's the same for Granite.
Maybe they all mean something.
Maybe the paws are
the hair.
I think he made some paint thing and he wanted to look ancient so he could be good.
And then you have a big sculpture. It makes it more interesting and not a boring place for just, it's just like a waste of land where you can have lots of other things on it where people will go and see it and use it.
That is inappropriate.
Why?
Can you see? She's nude.
Some stuff, like sculptures, you can't really interact with it. So stuff, you want to make stuff that people can interact with.
Touch it and get on it and stuff. People could, like, climb on it and touch it.
Yeah, it's funny, but it's inappropriate.
It's the right word.
Inappropriate seems to be the word of the day.
Yeah, inappropriate for the children, but I think it's quite...
It's very peculiar
for the adult.
You don't get sculptures that are something, you get sculptures that are just
anything that you picture, but you know what this is.
Embarrassed.
Why does it make you feel embarrassed?
Or they see their things and they
You never thought someone would do a sculpture of a person this big.
My least favourite bit was going to Liverpool Street because they were like, they were staring at us, and yeah, it was a private estate and we weren't allowed to film, but
them seeing us is like a little odd because not that much children like come to that group.
We didn't know and they were all businessy and stuck up. It was just like rude. Sculptures and water features makes you feel happy.
It's good.
Water features as well.
No,
that you can
everywhere.
Actually play with.
It's fun water. It's not like it's different water.
Got it. It's raining on the left.
Yeah.
Well, this is more London.
Yeah.
It's more about public spaces, what attracts the people. Because if there wasn't any other stuff that attracted people, they wouldn't come here.
I think adults will enjoy looking at it and feeling, but not as much as kids playing with it. Sometimes there's nothing in the city and you feel very bored, and when you see something you can like take pictures of it and show other people what you saw.
So do you think it's meant to be played in or just looked at?
Both really. It's meant to do anything in because it's just for anyone.
For children it's quite fun.
Are you making sure
splashing each other with water, but then again adults it's a different experience.
It can be whatever you want to be.
And there's loads of people here. Yeah. People don't stare at you here. And the art is much better as well. There are different shapes, and everything's not just made out of one thing.
It's like a dinosaur trying to break out or something, but it's really hard, and it's not really there for anything particularly.
I think it's an egg, but it says it's a full stop, and I like
it's
it.
It's called Full Stop Slipstream by Fiona Bannon.
You can't really do much with it. It's there to look at, which I don't think is very good.
Give it some colour, a multicolour bit, and put some lights up around it or like on it. It'd make it a bit more, and people more want to take more pictures of it because it'd be an unusual thing.
Some parks have lots of public art that people can go in and look.
You could see all the way from there. There's a big
up sword.
My
body is there.
Yeah, I like to climb on them. And you can have as much fun as you want, and there's stones underneath it so you can decorate it with whatever you want if no one's there.
It was fun. It was like I was surrounded by nature. And it was really nice, and I like the flowers especially.
That was scary!
It could be anything to try and make art everywhere. So anything can be art. And I want it to be for all ages and abilities.
Aimed at all ages. So even if you're like really old, you can still enjoy it. And if you're really young, you can enjoy it.
I'll do something that's really colourful.
The colours maybe.
And the shapes and sizes of things.
I'd love them to touch it. Ones where you can climb on it. Instead of having ones where you just look at and you can't touch, where it has that red rope around it.
There should be where lots of people come and it's really busy.
They can feel and maybe things that can, like they can sense.
Make it move or like make the sculpture, like play with the person.
To inspire you to do different things.
And develop your creative mind.
Yes.
Say you had a sculpture of a famous person, it could like, they could record that person's voice, they could make the different parts move, you could like shake its hand or something, and it would be really exciting to take pictures of.
I like ninjas, so I wanted to make a statue of a ninja. It swings its arms around and it has four buttons.
The different colours are different things.
Well, purple, so I thought that's quite a nice colour, so I thought it would be flowers, so I put flowers on it. This one's the sun, because these reflect the sun over it.
The one with the orange peel is a slide. When you slide down it, you smell and feel oranges.
So I was going to put tubes, like, next to them all, because in my real one I want water passing through it all and then splashes out at the end.
Shipwreck. Play area, and on the deck there were soft spikes on the floor. Underground fall pit with lots of slides and climbing frames.
Roundabout thing, and when you get on it, you just have to press like this button, and then it just like the water splashes out on you and it twists around, and it's really fun.
It's a wobbly slide. It's so colourful.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
And it wobbles on the way down.
Oh yeah.
It's kind of mysterious because you don't know what's inside. So you press the red button, then you crawl inside like a public space where most people go. Different experience that people never experienced before, and they start squaring you with anything.
Oh man, I couldn't believe that happened.
Then you don't know what's gonna happen.
The mirrors here reflect everything that's around it.
Whoa, it's massive.
And when the sun reflects on these tubes, it brings sunlight and it glows.
You have to go up the stairs and then they have to jump from here.
This is my tunnel slide, where there's a hole over here and then you have to climb up through the tunnel and then slide down, and then there's water at the bottom.
A massive hamster ball, and you can go inside it, and it's got loads of hamster apparatus, like running mill thing, the little tube, the water and the food, and then you can also go inside the hamster and you see its body parts, like the brain, the stomach, the heart and everything else.
The biggest one, the biggest oval shape, open so they can see the clown puppets moving around and stuff. They can go inside and explore the clown and stuff.
My box is this huge black box which is full of steam, and it's completely dark. But there's a luminous trail which glows in the dark that you can follow. There are these squidgy things. When you hit them, they make funny noises and they squirt water in your direction. When you walk past, they brush on your head and it scares you. And every 5 minutes, there's 10 seconds of light to find out where you are. And it's funny because you don't know who you're standing to because it's completely dark. And in one corner, there's this cafe when all the food is just black.
Yeah, that can be really entertaining for children, and maybe something like a sculpture, it can be like for children, inappropriate, or like appropriate for children to play on and look at.
Some people, like children, can climb on and they can have fun, and some of them should be where lots of people can see it and they can climb, so it should be where lots of people come and it's really busy.
Public art should be for all ages and abilities, and multicoloured and lovely to look at.
I think public art should be colourful because it makes it more exciting and able to climb.
I think public art should be interactive, so then everyone could enjoy.
I think public art should be art for everyone, that everyone can interact with, like, and disabled people as well, because they're obviously in wheelchairs. So I think it should be art that they can interact with as well, and it can be like anything.